Hello dear friends, welcome to EPG Pathshala. My name is Devraj Goyal, at present serving CIET NCERT New Delhi, India as Professor Educational Technology. Today we will reflect on Techno-Pedagogic Analysis under the course Perspectives, Issues and Research in Teacher Education. The objectives of the module are Techno-Pedagogic Skills. You will be in a position to analyze a program in terms of techno-pedagogic skills employed. Describe the digital scripting process. Design a video program employing techno-pedagogic skills. Appreciate any digital educational instruction program in terms of techno-pedagogic skills employed. Dear learners, the 21st century demands that every teacher from early childhood care and education through higher education and continuing education is a techno-pedagogue. Techno-pedagogy is a discipline which focuses on interviewing the principles of technology and pedagogy. Here you may be having a few questions like what is technology and what is pedagogy. Technology is application of various sciences, physical as well as social, in a systemic way for realization of objectives, whereas pedagogy deals in the principles of teaching. Every digital production which is meant for educational instruction ought to be based on the principles of techno-pedagogy. One of the principles of techno-pedagogy, as I was sharing with you, is media message compatibility. Long back, one of the communicologists, Marshall McLuhan, said that medium is message. It means medium should be messagenic and message should be mediagenic. It means there should be message media compatibility. Every message does not go with every medium. Some messages go with radio, some messages go with television, some messages go with computer, some messages go with print. So we have to decide how the messages could be distributed judiciously. Another principle is spatial and temporal contiguity of various message form. Balanced view composition and message media credibility, media fidelity. These days we talk of Wi-Fi and Hi-Fi, that is wireless fidelity and high fidelity. Our messages should go through the media unaffected. Media should be neutral. The messages should pass through the media. For that, we need to have Wi-Fi's and Hi-Fi's. We cannot not communicate. At the same time, communication is irreversible. When communication is irreversible, how to go about? Even before sending a message, we should mark that the text has its own testimony. And for realizing the testimony of the text, we should evaluate the message before it is sent. And more so in this digital age, that the moment is the message is formed, we say send, and the moment we send, the message goes. And when the message goes, we cannot take it back. So the communication is irreversible. And we cannot, as we say that, yes, correcting an erratic message is a figment of imagination. We cannot correct the message. Once it is left means left, and digital communication is such that it goes with the speed of light. It goes with the electromagnetic waves, and the speed of light, speed of electromagnetic waves is 3 × 10⁻¹⁰ centimeters per second, 7 times the circumference of the earth. It means a message can take round of the earth within 1/7 of a second. It can come back. So that is the speed, and when with this speed the message goes, it is back, very difficult to take it back. Once it goes, it means it goes, and more so through e-mode and digital communication. So there should be optimum communication control. A sea volume of MOOCs, that is massive open online courses and repositories, is no use unless it passes the principles of techno-pedagogy. Let us recall our first transition from home to school. Each one of us has a highly touching story to narrate because it is deeply feeling phenomenon. A child for the first time leaves home for school, where home and school facially both have different cores and cultures. Bondage between the child and home, child and peers, child and nature, child and school differ significantly. Home attracts and the school pulls. There is very often, rather always, a tussle between home and the school. The present study has made an attempt to techno-pedagogically analyze a film, Safar Ghar Se School Tak, for parents and teachers for facilitating first transition of a child from home to preschool. The techno-pedagogic analysis of the film has been done in terms of various techno-pedagogic elements, such as medium is message, temporal and spatial contiguity of various message forms, message credibility and media fidelity, message compatibility in totality, technological feasibility, technological fidelity, and pedagogic suitability, aspect ratio of picture and text, self-contained status and speed of delivery of the film, content and quality of the film in terms of various elements such as audio, video, frames, communication elements such as who says what, to whom, through which channel and with what effect, through correspondence amongst sender, message, medium and receiver. It is a digital age. The immediate focus of India is Digital India. It is to realize transparency by surfing through digital age skills such as skimming, scanning, skipping, switching, hyperlinking, and full immersion with scale and speed. Anywhere, anytime, any task, any field. It is not only for realizing transparency, but along with to realize recency, immediacy, and omnipresence through the speed of electromagnetic waves. Indian education has immediate focus on e-content development and communication. E-content development and transaction demands interweaving of content, pedagogy, and technology, employing various techno-pedagogic principles such as media message compatibility, temporal and spatial contiguity of various message forms such as picture, text and sound, message credibility, and media fidelity. It also demands production skills. There has to be judicious sharing of the shots by the different cameras, smooth transition from one to the other, controlling jacks while zooming out and zooming in. There has to be a perfect coordination amongst the different cameramen, producers, and shots selectors and mixer. Finally, it has to be quality production, observing all the quality parameters resulting into a perfect view composition. E-content have various quality parameters such as it ought to be original, mediagenic, concise and precise, interwoven and interesting, resulting into an attractive view composition. It has to be hi-fi and Wi-Fi, that is having high fidelity and wireless fidelity for wider coverage. Digital world demands digital culture, but use our digital volumes if not innovative. The digital has to observe its own testimony. Every bit of it has to be rich and reaching. For realizing this objective, the e-designing, development, production, and transaction have to be perfect. At times, there is quality and identity loss while duplicating, converting from one medium to the other medium, and losses during mediation and transmission. All these need to be controlled. It is true that no camera shots can capture the reality as it is, but the losses ought to be minimal. If not natural, then it should tend to be natural and self-contained. What use are the oceans of MOOCs and OERs, that is open education resources, if these lack originality? The e-form demands to be quintessentially innovative. The e-volumes have to be pioneer. Every e-production has to be original and innovative rather than mere conversion. Many problems are on the fore. We rarely meet our predicaments because what use are those feelings which do not emanate into action? Every e-content is expected to be an embodiment of our knowledge, values and skills. Who says high-tech is mechanistic? It can have deepest reach and highest touch. We need to develop digital culture in India. Cashless transaction in India cannot be realized overnight. It is because a large majority of us are not techno-literates. System conversion from one form to another has to be done in a highly civilized way. Direct conversion in one go at the massive level is rarely feasible. Suitably, we can go for parallel conversion, phased conversion, or modular conversion. The very aspiration of techno conversion overnight can create chaos. Modernization may not be civilization. Any conversion by anyone has to be done with all decency, decorum, and discipline, irrespective of who does it. E-conversion demands e-culture. Digital crowd in India is easily perceptible. Everyone is after e-production, whether e-literate or illiterate. Commerce is trying to superimpose all the disciplines. There are blind slips in the e-valleys, whether we like or not. E-forms will prevail. Before there is irreparable damage, let us try to develop e-culture. It is not a journey to fly and arrive at. We have to travel patiently. Enough of imitation. We ought to do indigenous production, observing relevance, quality, and compatibility. Steps of digital scripting process. Program ideas. All the digital scripts originate with the germination of an idea. My grandpa accompanied me to the municipal corporation school, which was miles away from home, walkie, and left me in standard one class, which was in the open under a peel tree in Haryana. The class teacher, Master Kashiram, only in the armchair. After some time, when the attention of the teacher diverted from me, I ran away with the speed of storm towards home. Grandpa on the way ran after me, caught hold, and again took me to the school. Again I ran away. This time I could skip the attention of Grandpa. When he reached home, he found me already there. Next day he purchased some orange slices on the way to the school, left me there and orange slices with the teacher, suggesting him to give those to me periodically and treat me affectionately, so as to retain me in the school. Well, it worked, and worked very well. Progressively, while guiding doctoral research in education, it clicked me that why not to produce a film for facilitating first transition of the children from home to school. This germination of the idea and incubation resulted into programming, production, and connection. Program brief. Then, based on the germination and incubation of the ideas, it was decided to script a film, Safar Ghar Se School Tak, for facilitating first transition from home to the preschool. It also provided a roadmap for how to proceed. Now we go on to program research. It is at this stage that the script writer must plan and carry out thorough research, both on the topic as well as target viewers, looking out for the related inputs on the topic. At this stage, it is important for the script writer to get to know the viewers well, their background, interests, likes and dislikes. It helps the script writer to collect, select, and organize relevant program materials most suitable for the viewers. Selection of contents. At this stage, the most relevant materials, visuals, sources and resources, and information which match the program objectives are decided or selected. Message planning. Here many considerations come into focus, such as identifying key concepts or ideas to be highlighted, selecting a suitable format for program presentation, exploring media possibilities such as use of examples and analogies, graphics, photographs, reality bites, stock shots, animation, experiments, and other sources and resources, both audio and visual. Choosing a definite storyline for message presentation, using human characters in the story, men, women, children, presenters, anchor, cartoons, puppets, animals, and birds. Dear learners, now let us discuss program structure and visual treatment. Here the script writer will give thought to such questions as follows. How will the program begin? How will the program end? what will be the shape and order of the sequences that will form the middle part? How many sequences will the program finally contain and in which order? What will be the length, sequence, emphasis, and amount of educational content of each of the sequences? To what extent the content of each of the sequences match the program objectives? If not fully, then how can content and objectives be matched optimally? Storyboard making. The storyboard means a detailed, short by short, description of the program on sheets of paper divided into two vertical columns. The rectangular boxes 3:4 in the left hand columns are used for drawing pictures, sketches with the short sizes described on each, and the right hand column is used for writing supporting words, sound effects, and music. Then draft script. The storyboard, when complete, leads to the preparation of a draft script. The draft script is the first full-length script that includes a complete listing and description of all visuals, captions, commentary, dialogues, actions, movements, music, sound effects, and any kind of pre-recorded inserts or audio-video inputs. The draft script must be discussed with all the team members, experts, as well as producer to get their reactions and suggestions on various aspects. The script writer must be open to criticism and ideas. Now, we go on to the final script. Now, the final script is prepared and passed on to the producer after considering and incorporating the suggestions. This is how the scripting of the film Safar Ghar Se School Tak was done. Then the film was converted to the digital form. Rationale of the study. Wish our schools could tend to be like our home. This is a pious expectation, but only a figment of imagination. The over-discipline, mechanized classrooms, incompatible curricula, dull modes of transaction, less emphasis on teaching learning, and more on examination have made our educational institutions dull and dreary, where beauties of childhood are destroyed, energies of the adults are wasted, and the prime of the youth is killed. Could our education be cultured right from the induction of a child to the exit of a youth? For that, we ought to revive and sustain our educational cultural heritage and set the modernization pace very carefully. Our education policy has to be perfect. The present paper attempts to analyze a film, Safar Ghar Se School Tak, technopedagogically to facilitate first transition of a child from home to school so that the education is compatible rather than mechanical. Objectives of the study. To study the perceptions of Educational Multimedia Research Center, EMRC, students on the technopedagogic skills interwoven in a film, Safar Ghar Se School Tak. Research methodology, population. All the students of the EMRC in India. The film, Safar Ghar Se School Tak, was produced by Mrs. Sucheta Jasrai, a doctoral scholar of CASE, that is Center of Advanced Study in Education, Faculty of Education and Psychology, the Maharaja Sayajirao University of Vadodara, Gujarat, India. It is an award-winning film, adult category of the CEC, that is Consortium of Education Communication, New Delhi. Sample, one student of BSc, Electronic Media, 6 students of MSc, Electronic Media, and 18 students of MBA, Media Management, Devi Ahilya Vishwavidyalaya Indore constituted the sample, total 25 for the study. The sample was drawn conveniently and purposively. Tools and techniques. A perception scale of 25 items on 5 point, excellent, very good, good, poor, very poor, and an open-ended item for seeking suggestions on improving the film was constructed by the investigator. Also, focus group discussion was conducted with the sample students. Data collection. The film was screened on 26/11/2016 in the conference hall of the EMRC DAVV Indore. The sample students viewed the film. After that, the perception scale was administered, followed by the focus group discussion. Data analysis. The data with respect to the 25 closed-ended items were analyzed in terms of frequencies and percentage responses, whereas the responses to the open-ended item were content analyzed. Table presents the data analysis. The table is on perception of EMRC students on the techno-pedagogic skills interwoven in the film Safar Ghar Se School Tak to facilitate first transition of children from home to preschool. It is evident from the table that the frequencies greater than 75% of the responses have been registered on the points excellent, very good and good against all the 25 statements, representing the techno-pedagogic skill level of the film. The quality of the film could be enhanced by further focusing on the entire view composition of the film. The masses media technology integration was found to be compatible. There was spatial and temporal contiguity of the various masses forms such as audio, video and text. Testimony of the text and fidelity of the media were well observed. The content, pedagogy and technology were found to be well interwoven. There was ample content validity, pedagogic suitability and technology integration. Aspect ratio of the pictures and text was observed reasonably. The quality of the message was observed. The audio and video stimuli were found to be powerful. The view composition of the film was found to be balanced in terms of background, configuration, foreground, and the entire view. The film was found to be self-contained. The speed of delivery was found to be suitable. The level of attention was found to be at the level of the full immersion. The film could reasonably facilitate the first transition of children from home to preschool. The film was found to have medium level of deployability because it was delimited to an urban school setting. As a whole, the film was found to be at the midpoint of the 5-point scale, that is good. Suggestions for improving the quality of the film Safar Ghar Se School Tak. The suggestions made by the respondents are presented as follows on the basis of content analysis of the open-ended item. The film chose a very rare topic. More such concepts should be chosen to depict unspoken and unexpressed feelings. The audio quality could have been improved. The speed of delivery could be enhanced. The music could be of better quality. The shots taken could have been more creative. Children have so many expressions. They are excellent actors. Their expressions could be valuably utilized. The present day schools have changed. Children have changed. New technology can be used for the film production. Safar Ghar Se School Tak is a good documentary on the teaching system of India on how a child starts school life from home to school. Though there are some commonalities, but the adoption varies from child to child. We could add thinking of the present day parents with respect to their words. Many more dimensions such as education system, child behavior, financial position of parents could also be included, which affects the child behavior. Scenario of only one private school has been produced. The public school scenario could also be produced. The film production could have been done with advanced technology. The content is good, but the video quality could be improved. If the film is reproduced with visuals of today's scenario and society, then it will have better appeal. Sound was faster than the visuals. The film speed was fast. There could be blank audio space for assimilation of the flowing messages. Poetry related to childhood could find place in the film. Problems and confusion of parents could be still discussed along with solutions. Presentation of a few success stories could enhance the effect. Show the new play schools which are filled with new themes and projects. Video quality could be improved. Even the educated parents are not aware of making their children ready before sending them to school. The parents should create school-like atmosphere at home for preparing children for school. The interviewer should not put the same stereotyped question to all the parents. There could be a variety of expressions. She could interact with the children also. Characters could be more attractive. Visual quality could be better, as well as the background music related to the conditions of transition of the children. Add subtitle in English or English version could also be produced with Hindi captions. Sound quality and voice quality could be improved. Technical disturbance in sound could be controlled. Messages could have been more appealing. Framing could have been better. Visual and audio mismatch could be controlled. Interaction amongst the parents and teachers could be organized after school and recorded. Lip syncing could be better. Better scenes and background music could be added. Teachers' point of view should be there. A scene where parents making their children understand about going to school could be added. Some of the visuals could be better quality. There should have been added focus on dialogues. Some games taught by the teachers could be short. More of animation could have been added. Camera angles and view composition must improve. More sound effects could be added. The jacks in zoom in and zoom out could be controlled. The placing of the tips could have been at the end or just before the conclusion so that it could be more effective. We could add a bit more interviews with the experts. The interviews with the teachers could also help. The content was good, but at times there were distractions which could be controlled through background music. We can change the frame and technology for the visual medium for the film. New technology could be utilized for audio of the film. We could take new places for shooting. We could talk to children as well as more number of experts. At the end, there could be a caption that come and know the views of children, but no views are shown on how children feel on the first day of their school. Now, the concluding remarks. The film Safar Ghar Se School Tak has been well designed, developed and produced techno-pedagogically. It is a quality film for facilitating the first transition of the children from home to preschool. The utility of the film could be enhanced by screening it in various localities and schools by adding subtitles in English and other languages. There is no end to perfection. Voices of the children and teachers, soothing sights of the schools, aspect ratio of the pictorial and textual, suitable frame size, sensitivity of the presenters such as lip syncs and speed of delivery, expertise of more experts and production skills like controlling jacks while zooming out and in, and correspondence between the anchor and camera could definitely enhance the quality of the film. The film has been found to be definitely useful for parents and teachers in facilitating the first transition of children from home to preschool. Every e-content for education ought to be original and techno-pedagogical. Digital culture demands originality and validity of contents and techno-pedagogic compatibility. Any techno-pedagogue should faithfully live by the principles of techno-pedagogy, such as medium is message, spatial and temporal contiguity of message forms, message credibility and media fidelity, media language proficiency, resonance of sender, message and medium, and receiver, interweaving of content, maxims of teaching, and principles of technology. Techno-pedagogy can deterministically facilitate quality teaching learning by employing various skills and principles easily and precisely. There is a need to develop digital educational culture in India right from early childhood care and education. Thank you. It has been a lovely experience to be with you, initiating myself into the area of first transition of children from home to preschool. Hope it facilitates the first transition.